What important factors that we have to consider before we're gonna start up with this kind of farming?
There are four basic. Number one is sunlight. You have the proper water source, aeration, and nutrient.
Hi guys, it's a beautiful day once again, and welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Well, I believe in the saying of good karma. These are the principles that are adopted by people who become very successful. If you do good for others, then many blessings would come along the way. And this is my principle also, to do good to other people, to share our knowledge, basic techniques on farming, so that they can also start their own. And today, I am so privileged enough to have a visitor. And in my previous blog, I already have mentioned his name, J&G's Backyard Lettuce. And actually, he is here, and his name is Carl Julius. And I'm so glad because we've been talking through internet, of course, through emails, and even through text messages about the possibility of having a collaboration. And this were actually not very clear before, but now I am so glad that he is here. He was able to come here yesterday via airplane. If you will know that this city where I live in is in the island of Mindanao, and that's too far from the island where Julius is staying. He's in Luzon. But he managed himself, together with his beautiful wife, to come here in order to help us. And actually, this help is unlimited because he will not only share with us about the techniques, the basic tenets on hydroponics, but he also gave us the materials to start up with the greenhouse. And actually, you will see that we have so many materials right here. We have the styrofoam, we have this PVC pipes, and we have this controller. And all of this, including the UV plastic, have been given for free to us. Actually, I'm so proud and I'm so happy to announce that this is now the product of the good deeds that we are sharing to other people. And we are now reaping the fruits of our labor. We sow good deeds and we receive also good favors to other persons. And now I would like you to welcome our visitors, of course, none other than Julius and Jedan.
Gracias. After 2 months of communicating, we arrive here at the Latin city of the Philippines.
Welcome.
Welcome, bro. This is Mom Jed and Julius. I'm glad that we are met.
Yeah.
Finally. Okay. And I would like to share to you some points of hydroponics and the techniques.
Yeah.
We've been practicing all over, and hopefully my success will be also your success.
Yeah. And I'm so glad to introduce to you my friends, Julius and Jedan. They're actually husband and wife, and I'm so proud of them because they're already very successful in this lettuce farming and other types of vegetables through hydroponics. And I was given the t-shirt. You look at this one, guys, very beautiful. And we have the same, of course, the hydroponics, 100% fresh. Please greet our friends, our followers on Dexter's World.
Hi, Dexter's World channel.
Yeah.
Hello. Nice to meet you guys.
Yeah. So, Sir Julius, I'm so glad that you are here. And this is one of a lifetime opportunity to be visited by a person who has so much knowledge about this hydroponic farming. And let me ask you, what are the important factors that we have to consider before we're gonna start up with this kind of farming?
Okay, so before I start, I would like to say thank you, Dexter, for allowing me to share my knowledge. But basically, those of you viewers, there are four basic. Number one is sunlight. Mm-hmm. Now, morning sunlight or facing the east side is very important. And number two, water. You have the proper water source. If the water is clean, then that's very good material.
Oh yeah.
And you have to find out that aeration and nutrients is very important also. So sunlight, water, aeration, and nutrients.
Wow, that's amazing. What about you, ma'am? Can you greet our friends out there?
Hi, Dexter's World, here.
Yeah.
We're about to share our knowledge in hydroponics.
Yeah.
And how we can help Dexter to plant and grow more lettuces.
And I would like to take this opportunity to thank them in front of you guys for the blessings that they extended to us. As what I have said, these are all given for free just for me to start up. Can we call this a trial and error process? I really would like to start small and think big.
So in this system, I will share to him the two kinds of system in hydroponics. One is the Kratky bed type and two is the NFT system. So these two system will eventually the system of large scale hydroponic system, wherein you can notice these kinds of system, especially NFT and deep water culture Kratky, in other countries like USA, like Japan, like France. So here is the materials we use in NFT. We will be using the 2x4 pipes. This material will serve as the planting media or planting bed. We will have to make a hole. We will have to observe proper spacing, because if this will be placed in proper, then you will have to produce more lettuce and bigger lettuce.
So guys, we are now set with our PVC pipes. This is a square pipe that we normally use in hydroponics through adapting the NFT method. Julius can tell us how much we will possibly earn out of this very little space by selling this lettuce in the future.
So our target is 230 holes in this area, sizing for about 1.30 meters. So 1.30 meters. So we will be targeting at least 8,000.
That's the proceeds. Right. Yeah. If we are going to multiply the 230 pieces times 35 pesos, that's gonna be around 8,000 pesos, more or less. Yeah. With this very limited space and with this kind of setup, you will be earning an income of 8,000 pesos.
If you guys are aiming for a business, might as well, you have to taste it, we have to test it with your family first, and then later the business will follow.
Yeah.
So that is farming, because some other guys are taught about, they engage into farming, they have money, they have go into business, but later on they will stop.
Yeah.
Because the passion and the vision, they neglect it.
Yeah.
So we need to practice. Mm. That's why I am here sharing the knowledge, and Dexter will practice again.
Yeah.
And hopefully I will come back here and we will have to make a larger greenhouse.
Hopefully, and that's really my desire, to convert this into a commercial scale. But I'm afraid that if we will spend too much of the materials, the greenhouse, which is very large and made of steel, this gonna entail some big budget. Because I really don't know about this hydroponic thing. So I contacted Julius, and Julius is really a good man, because aside from providing us with these materials, he also provided us with the top secret on how to go about these things. And these secrets are actually revealed on his channel. That's why I am his number one avid fan. And I've been subscribed to his channel for how many years back. And that is the reason why we had a communication, because he is also my subscriber and I am also his subscriber, a follower. I admire this guy because he don't withhold information. And this is the reason why I would like to ask you to please subscribe to his channel You just type what?
JNG Bacter lettuce or kagulay.
Kagulay on YouTube.
On YouTube.
Do you also have Facebook account?
Yes, JNG Bacter lettuce also.
And I know that there are many technical questions that I am not ready to answer yet because, as you know, I'm new to this business. But then, if you will ask the expert and you will watch all his videos, actually, he also uses English language as his medium of communication in his channel. And those of you guys who are in the foreign land, meaning you're not a Filipino, you can just easily understand what he's saying about because he is using English. And I am so proud and very confident to recommend the channel of this guy.
As a teacher, I don't spoon-feed. I want them to experience. I want them to realize how hard it is to produce a crop. And that's why they have gained respect for farmers. You will have to value food. That is the basic information I provide in my channel. And all you need to do is to follow that basic and apply. And hopefully realize that this is gonna work for you. And this is not gonna work for you because we have the different setting, we have different
climate.
We need to have a sunlight, you need to have a good water and source of nutrients, and that's it. It's gonna work.
If you guys can subscribe, I know that you will learn so many things, like what you have learned in the videos that you can see in Dexter's World channel. So guys, Julius made this hole for us. This will be fearfully done because if you are not expert on this, you might damage the PVC pipe. And you will see that it has a distance of at least 6 to 8 inches. This gives us a good space for this lettuce to grow big and they will not get overcrowded.
So guys, we are now here at the NFT system. This is 18 pipes all in all. We are going to adjust. There are some space we need to follow so that we can be able to grow here a very, very nice lettuce. After finalizing the space, we are going to connect all the pipes using the connector of these PVC pipes. So guys, we're gonna apply sealant to the connectors so that there will be no leak, okay, in our NFT system. So let's proceed with putting the sealant first.
So we are actually maximizing our time. We're running short of time because they will fly back to Manila early tomorrow. And you will see that Julius is now fixing the joint of this PVC pipes because this is very important. We don't want to have a leak in the flow of this water because according to my seminar, the lessons that Julius have imparted to me, leaking is a big and serious problem because this will waste our water with nutrients. So we will be wasting our nutrients, so we will prevent any leaks to happen. Ensuring that the leaking will not gonna happen, we will secure the joints of this. Well, you know that these PVC pipes have a connector, and this connector would probably and potentially become the source of the leak. So we are doing it now. We are fixing everything so that we will have a better NFT system.
So Dexter, we will have to first make a hole. Mm-hmm. This is actually the material we will use for Kratky method.
Okay, yeah.
Bed type Kratky method, which is developed and mastered by Joey Vergara, my friend from Leyte.
Hi Joey.
And now we will have to measure it first, 4 inches side to side.
Okay.
Edge, 4 inches.
So the distance is 4 inches.
4 inches
between the holes,
side, and then between the holes is 8 inches.
8 inches.
So you're gonna use improvised material, and you'll have to make a hole like this one. So we're gonna make 18.
18 holes.
Okay. So let's proceed. You know, Dexter, this is also the counterpart of soil preparation in organic or in soil farming.
Yeah.
But this one is, you may do it just once. These materials is a lifelong material.
So you guys can see that we already have completed holing this styrofoam. And actually we have 18 holes. And you will see that there's a foam over here, which will be the holder of our seedling, sprouted lettuce, and that's gonna be the content of maybe this video or next video.
There are lots of materials that can be used, but this is our best option to use styro, because styrofoam will not heat easily and it is cheaper than the plywood. So you can use plywood, but you cannot easily make a hole. Well, in fact, using hydroponic system, you can plant anywhere. If you don't have lot, if you don't have a farm or field, you can use your balcony.
Yeah.
You can use your terrace.
Rooftop.
You can use your sidewalls.
Yeah.
As long as there is sunlight,
yeah,
there is water, there is oxygen or aeration and nutrients.
So guys, we are actually slicing a piece of this styrofoam, and I don't know what's the use of this. What's the use of this?
We will be using styrofoam for our pipe.
Okay.
So that it will be like somewhat stopper.
Yeah.
So that the water will take in or drip, it will go straight at the end of the gutter.
And it goes back to the tank where we mix this solution.
So others may use this pipe, and then they will cut this portion of this, and then they will bend down.
Okay, so this is very innovative. Actually, if you will just think of ways and how to do your thing, well, you can make it simple by just using the styrofoam. Of course, we can also use the sealant, the silicone, with the silicone gun, and then we can seal this one. And we will be assured that the water will not go back, or I mean, it will not drip out. It will continuously flow in and goes back to the drum where we put this nutrients. Yeah.
Okay.
So as simple as that. So our next process will be preparing the seedlings. And of course, we will use this styro cup. Since this is very close, so we will make a breather out of this. We will slice something.
Portion.
For a portion of this, 2 inches or three, or maybe less. 1 inch.
Two
inches, so that we can have an opening and the water can come in, and it will also provide oxygen. I know this because I already had that seminar, and in fact, I already had the certificate of completion of the training.
Hold the cup like this. Make sure the hole is not facing you. Okay, make sure the hole is
against you.
Towards against you. And then all you need to do is to aim and then down. All right.
Just like that?
Yes.
It's too easy.
Yes. Sometimes people may cut the portion of this at the center, and then it depends. It depends because other practices may be
vary.
Effective.
Yeah.
From their own practices, and this is farming.
Yeah.
You have to analyze, you have to do what are the practices we make here, just to simplify the process so that you can do it in your own at home. So guys, in the Philippines, there are lots of coconut trees around us, especially in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So the coco coir is somewhat the best organic media in hydroponics. But you can use, if you have to buy horticulture foam, you can have it. In this video, we're gonna make it simple as it is. So guys, this is a very simple tip, okay? Just make it lighter, okay? Do not press, okay? Harder, so that it will you can transplant it easily.
Yeah.
So Dexter, after making a holes, making a slit on the styro cup, after filling all the coco coirs inside the styro cup, we will now transplant the small lettuce, or baby lettuce. This is about 15 days old, okay? So we are not going to do it like this because after 30 days, okay, Korean barbecue, right? So you're gonna do it this way.
Okay.
So you have to dig a hole, make sure, okay, the roots are intact.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
And then you have to make it at the center. So guys, we are done with transplanting method. We are now going to transfer it so that our seedlings is very safe. So guys, after transplant, they need to recover. You will be putting water so that they can drink and rest. So guys, I put 2 deeper of water so that the plants will drink and they can rest throughout the night. And they will stay here at least 2 days or 3 days, as long as they can recover. We will immediately put it to the NFT system.
So we have so many options to cover the end part of this PVC pipe, and the option that we chose is to just put this styrofoam, and we will just cut a piece of it that will suit or fit in the end part of this to prevent the water from getting out, and we will just use the silicone to fix everything, and that's gonna be fine. So guys, finally we have done fixing everything, and we will make an update about the progress of this. And guys, please allow me to tell you something. Please allow me to express my feeling right now. I'm so happy to have Jedan and Carl here in our place. They're actually traveling as far as Manila, that's the island of Luzon. That's actually how many miles away from here in the city or in the island where I am situated. They have to travel by plane for more than 2 hours, and of course I understand the tedious task that they have to undergo just to be able to reach here in this place and to share with us their expertise about this hydroponics through NFT. And they are so generous in giving us this information. Actually, this information is $1 million worth, actually. And they are giving this information for free. And aside from that, they are giving us these materials in order for us to have this video and to give vital information to you guys, our followers and our viewers. And let me ask a Christmas gift from you. Of course, today is December, and it is my first time to ask a gift from you guys, my subscribers and followers. Please, I'm begging you as my Christmas gift, please subscribe to their channel. And what's the name of your channel?
JNG Backyard Lettuce.
And it's all about?
It's all about hydroponics farming, basic tips, basic information, and all you need to do is to follow those basic tips.
And you have to browse all their videos from day one to present, and they're revealing basic tips, basic information, very useful for us to become successful in the field of hydroponics.
And we offer a commercial hydroponic system, and we have a different fee on that.
Yeah, and the business is on, actually. If you would like to have this kind of setup, feel free to contact the number below. I am going to provide also the link of their channel and the personal number where you're gonna contact them in case you wanted to have this kind of setup or even in a commercial setup. This is actually a compact services where they're gonna install all these things with free seminar and information. And to tell you frankly, my understanding about hydroponics through NFT had been changed, totally changed. I can say that I have now back up and understand whatever is happening right now. We will prosper together. We will venture and dream for the biggest thing to happen in our lives in the field of this kind of business. If you are not subscribed to this channel, may I humbly ask you to please subscribe and hit that notification bell for you to be notified of our regular uploads only here at Dexter's World.